MI A2 has launched, but with a few compromises. What are those? Let's find out in this video after a short intro, and then we get on to all of the features, all of the specs, and how I feel about the MI A2 or the Mi 6X. So this is Tanushu Aswa from Eccentric Tech. If you're new to this channel, hit on that red subscribe button just like this red smartphone, and that will turn it black, not the smartphone, that subscribe button. And then you will be greeted with a bell icon, and just hit it and you'll get all the future tech updates from this channel right here. So this is Tanushu Aswa from Eccentric Tech. Let's begin. So what we have first is the display. The fabulous display by Xiaomi is 5.99 inch, and that's 18:9. So it's a full HD plus panel LCD, and not AMOLED, so not the best, but it's good. And then second thing we move on to is the fingerprint scanner, which is improved, and it's, according to Xiaomi, the best fingerprint scanner used on a smartphone, by Xiaomi of course. And then we have cameras. Cameras has become one of the main deciding factors of a smartphone by Indian users. So this smartphone has a good camera. The front facing camera is a 20 megapixel camera with a f1.75 aperture, and the back cameras are two. One is 12 megapixel f1.75 and second is 20 megapixel f1.75. If you don't want to get onto the numbers, is what this exactly means is that the aperture of a single pixel is small. That means the actual camera sensor is big and more light will be captured. That's what the difference is between a DSLR with a big camera lens and a smartphone camera with a smaller camera lens. That's why smartphone cameras struggle at night photography, whereas DSLRs don't. And with something as low as 1.75, it might actually bring on the camera game to a next level. I love camera, at least the sensors used on this smartphone are awesome. If the software is optimized correctly, it might turn out to be an awesome camera phone too. And Xiaomi has not compromised on the internals too. In all the sensors, including the accelerometer or the gyroscope, are present, and there are no compromises. What is a compromise is the lack of a headphone jack. I know you didn't expect this, no one did, and we didn't actually pay attention to the leaks and rumors, the bottom panel. So I think this is the official end of headphone jacks. RIP, it was good when it lived, and we will remember you. And OnePlus 6 is rumored to retain it. I don't know, might be 1 or 2 years, but I think the removal of headphone jack is the future. The internals are also awesome, and they basically compensate for the headphone jack. The internals is a Snapdragon 660, and the GPU is the Adreno 510 GPU, which is overall a very good combination of CPUs and GPUs. And we have seen this on the Oppo R11, which performed absolutely awesome. That unfortunately didn't come to India, but this actually does, and I will discuss it at the end of the video. So what we move on to from here is the pricing. Yes, this is the moment. We know the pricing, and I'm going to tell you after the short commercial from me. Subscribe to my channel, guys, please. I require more subs. I need to maintain this channel because 10 standard is killing this channel. So if you want to see more videos, go ahead, subscribe to my channel, and then I can keep on making vids. So actually I forgot the battery part. Battery is a 310 mAh battery, which is low, but it supports quick charge 3.0. so, and quick charge 3.0 plus low battery capacity means a thin phone. Yes, 7.3 mm thickness. And second is the charging speeds are awesome on this smartphone. Also, it comes bundled with a quick charge 3.0 supported charger, so don't worry about that. Then what we move on to from here is the pricing. I've created a lot of build up. So pricing is The 332GB variant comes for about 1599 yuan, which translates to about 15,500 rupees. The 464GB variant comes in around 1799 yuan, 17,500 rupees. The 6GB, 128GB variant comes in around for 1999 yuan, which is around 19,500 Indian rupees. So this was all the conversions. I think the base pricing is good enough. I think it should stay there, but the top end pricing should come down by at least 1,000 or 2,000. Both of them actually should. The 17,000 variant should launch in about 16,500 price, and the last top end variant should launch about 17,500, and that would make sense. But what I do think is that if it even launches, the top end variant launches for 20,000 mark, it won't have much competition there. The Moto X4 is there without a 18:9 panel. It is thick, it has glass which breaks. Many disappointments there. And it also has a Snapdragon 660, comes in 23,000 rupees. So I think this is a good phone for Xiaomi to launch in India. But yeah, for sure, it will be bashed a lot. It will be not bought for a lot because of a lack of 3.5mm headphone jack. But what I told you is the same. You should get used to it. And this was Tarun Srivastava from Eccentric Tech. One last thing. Do you like the removal of 3.5mm headphone jack or not? Answer in this poll. Then we move on to the last segment, which is please subscribe to my channel. Once again, I'm telling you guys, and I told you the reason I need more subscriber to show to my parents that I can do this thing, and I do need to focus on 10 too. So that's a big of a problem, and I'm trying to fix what I can do. So let's wait and watch. So this is Tarun Srivastava from Eccentric Tech. If you like this video, go ahead, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon, hit the share button and share to your friends. Comment down below what you liked, what you didn't. So this is Tarun Srivastava from Eccentric Tech. Peace.